Okay, so we have performed the basic configuration of KW Hotel 3. Now it is time to discuss room groups. As a hotelier, you are very well familiar with the concept. If you have rooms that share the same price range, standard, or inventory, these can be considered room groups. So if we think about single rooms, double rooms, premium, deluxe, queen, and so on, these are room groups. And why are they so essential for using in KW Hotel 3? I have prepared a few examples. So to begin with, they allow you for a much faster room search. Given the fact that there are quite a few ways to search for rooms in KW Hotel, this is a great, great addition. Secondly, it helps you organize the structure of your rooms, which basically means that it will be very, very simple to read your calendar, to answer customer requests on the spot, and so on. Thirdly, it allows you to use rate plans. I will not dwell into details. I will not discuss rate plans right now. There will be a different video. But believe me, you want to use rate plans, so you definitely have to create room groups right now. And the last but not least, if you ever upgrade to KW Hotel Standard or Pro version, you can automate the management of your reservation portals, such as Booking.com or Expedia. If you think about having few different booking portals, think that you have to log into each one of them manually and set your availability, set your rates, and so on. With KW Hotel Standard or Pro, you can forget it, because instead, you put all information in KW Hotel, and this information is automatically sent to your booking portals. And on the other hand, if there's any reservation created in, for example, booking.com, it will be automatically downloaded to your KW Hotel. So this is a huge time saver. It also greatly reduces the number of overbookings, so you lose less money and you have less frustrated customers standing in front of your reception. And the last but not least, you can use this time that you have just saved to work on other projects related to your hotel or to your free time, and so on. Okay, guys, the presentation is over. Let's get back to where we left off last time and let's create room groups. So, by default, we have two room groups already created. They are here on the right. And I want to show you how to create them from the scratch, so I will delete them first. What you have to do, you simply select the single room group and you click delete. Then you highlight the double room group and again, you press delete. And now let's discuss the part on the left. First of all, you have the hotel to choose. If you have a standard or pro version, you can have multiple hotels on a single database. This is more commonly used for the pro version's sake because it can be working in an online database, okay? And this is why it works great, because you can access your database from different computers or from mobile application and so on. In the free version, you only have a single hotel, so we are not really bothered by this field, okay? So, how to create a room group? This is very simple. What I do is I write, for example, single room group. I highlight the number of single and double beds. So in my case, there will be a single bed, no double beds. And I click add. Having done that, I can return to the left and I write double. And again, we change the single beds to zero and double beds to one. So single bed means one person can sleep in it, okay? And double bed means you can accommodate two persons, okay? And when I have done that, I click add. And you can do the same steps for any other room group you may have. And if you haven't really thought you have any room groups in your hotel, think how to organize the existing rooms depending on their standard, price, or inventory. And I'm sure you can find out how to do it. And remember, room groups can help you immensely when it comes to making your work faster and more efficient. So I really, really encourage you to do this now. And once you have done that, you click next. You wait for the room groups to be created in the database. And now in the next video, I will quickly show you how to include these rooms, include rooms in these room groups. Sorry. And the last but not least, make no mistake here, KW Hotel can be used not only for hotels, it can also be used for hostels, resorts, apartment rental, we have a unique solution for that actually. So I'm just, for the sake of this tutorial, I'm showing you how to do it for the hotel's perspective, but I will pin your article to our help center. I'll pin you a link to the help center, and there you can find solutions for other types of accommodations, okay? So I'll see you in the next lesson. Thanks.